picks it up.
Hello. We're back. Hi, everybody. How's it going? It's me and the bird. Don't do anything cute while I'm talking, bird. Okay. Hi, everybody. Nice to see you all. Let's talk about psychonauts, too. We still got open hires.
We have some open hires. Gameplay programmers.
What's that?
Hire the bird.
Hire the bird?
That's your PR right there.
I mean, she is our most popular face so far. James Spafford, would you like to update people on our communications and marketing?
At the end of next week, Jeff, Gigi, and Vic and I are going over to Boston to PAX. We'll take the Lobato demo, and we'll play Samurai Gun with people, and we will avoid getting the coronavirus. That is our main mission.
Yeah. If possible, if at all possible.
So, the helmet effort's gonna be led by Emily.
Very first part, the eye shrine, is gonna go to E3.
I'm gonna get Tim.
Some of the bigger, more iconic character-based moments from the first game were the boss fights. And I think some of the levels that we cut them from really need them.
Have we talked about the one-year out meeting at all?
No, I don't know. Have we ever talked about the one-year out meeting? When a game was a year out from being shipped or within that, Microsoft likes to know what the game's about. So yeah. We have to make a presentation to them about, like, this is Psychonauts 2. So it's mostly because they're like, okay, we need a year to plan selling this thing. What is this game we're going to be selling? And us explaining it to them. So that's going to be happening when?
It's March 6th.
March 6th. Friday, March 6th.
But the team doesn't have to do anything for it, right?
Nope.
That'll be fun.
I think I might get to ask for more money, too. That'll be super fun. Yeah. Super excited about having to do that.
So it's more about, like, this is what we have, and it's going to be great.
He missed me with this and a chicken McNugget and a donut from my desk.
Okay, so we're still getting exposure problems.
Mm-hmm. We just finished milestone 11. We have milestone 12, which is going to wrap up all of our levels getting to alpha. So the final date we have is May 1st. We want to be in a state where we can play through all the levels. We are on track for that. We're also putting together an E3 demo, which is the level we're going to use is already looking really, really good. So I'll be meeting with some people who are involved with that effort later this week.
We did it. You built a level.
No, it's definitely something. It happened. Okay, so what do we need to do? What do we want?
What is the most useful
feedback? All right, Andy, how long do we have left?
In this room?
Well, in life.
Yeah, on this earth.
All right. There are 8 working days left in this milestone.
Woo-woo! Okay.
8. Uh-huh. So all there the tasks that you should be putting up on the board today, starting on Tuesday, should be in reference to what you can get done in 8 days.
Mm-hmm. I just gotta close up some holes and stuff. Like, for the most part, everything's in.
The other thing was the eyeballs.
Oh, right.
The eyeballs that track the player.
Yeah, I think
what?
The eyes looking. Eyes looking.
All the eyes are looking. That all works. I'm doing it in materials. There's no CPU cost.
What?
See, they look. The eyeballs look at you.
They do look at you.
Oh my god, they do.
Can you pluck them off the bush?
Oh god. Why is that guy not looking at you?
It's fine.
He's breaking. Don't stop showing breaking. Yeah,
we're gonna put a secret down. We can talk about making tasks, or we can play the video games. Sorry. You can't do both.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. You're cleaned out then. Okay, that was all I had.
Okay. Those are all the things?
That was all the things.
All the things.
So we captured a lot of stuff.
What about clam?
Clam is very good at estimating his work, mm-hmm. so I'm going to trust that you've got that under control. And also, it's 5 o'clock, and I'm on fucking fire in this room, so...
do you know if we have to be on the Xbox?
No, fuck no.
Yeah, are we just doing all PCs there?
Yeah.
Okay, so that makes it a hell of a lot easier.
Oh, if Microsoft said we really need you to run on target hardware, I would go, fuck you.
I think I was kind of a dick in the last one.
Andy, what are you saying that I need to do better?
I don't know. We all just need to get better at following through what it is we want to make. I can't. It's a lot of talking about what we want to do and not a lot of writing it down.
Okay, there, Andy.
This is fucking madness. I can't do the Post-its anymore. I can't do it. I just can't fucking do it with the Post-it. It's too much. It's becoming a full-time job chasing Post-its. So we sit down and have these meetings. Everyone's just like, yeah, I don't know. We talk, and everyone talks about stuff, but no one's like, you, what are you doing? Okay, how many points is that worth? Okay, you, what are you doing? Like, I can't get people to pay attention. And it's freaking me out. But we're here to kind of talk about if there's improvements, or there's things we can do, things we need to change, or things that aren't even considered. Part of this, I will admittedly say right now, you know what this doesn't account for? Bosses. Do we want, are bosses being in the video game a requirement of alpha? Probably. So we're gonna try to hash this all out. And if my count is correct, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 proposed. Compton, Bobsey, Hollis, Maligula, Helmet.
Well, I mean, we have yet to put a fully functioning boss into the game that everybody is just, like, fully supportive of.
How long did the bosses take in Psychonauts 1?
Forever.
Forever.
What happened
to... Can I get a quantifiable amount of time instead of infinity?
Yeah, it's under 5 years. Three.
We're working on 7 levels simultaneously, just so you know. I mean,
yeah.
Yeah. I mean, the tricky thing with Hollis is, like, we've spent, like, a year on it or something like that,
mm-hmm.
like, between all the iterations of it. So it's
probably
like,
longer.
Probably longer than a year.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
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 Thanks, everybody.
But I think you should wait for 10.
Well, let's get started.
Okay, so.
Because all the other ones I've heard one or two good ideas for, I feel like.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we haven't done anything for Bob Z, but I've heard some really good intentions to have some good ideas, mm-hmm. right? So Compton, let's start with that, because I know there's a big judge thing in there, but I was questioning whether that the special judge was enough of a boss, because it was like just another judge that you fought. I mean, they are new in that level, but. Yeah. The puppets are bigger than the judge, is one thing. Yeah. Like, so it'd be neat if you fought them or cut their strings or something, like they're being...
Yeah, I mean, it'd be easy enough to just have them, like, flop into the space.
Have you played the Hall's boss? Do you like it?
I hate it.
And it is an octopus.
And it's got to be the octopus, because you made and tying it into the fact that your original sin of what you committed, the horrible thing you did to Hollis's brain, it's got to undo that. It's right. Got to kill the octopus you created, and it's got to break the mental connection. That could be a cutscene at the end, but
yeah. Okay.
Cool. Then we get into the next act.
Which is
Cassie and Bobsey.
Bobsey's big, you whale. It's a big angry plan.
Yep.
And then
or ship battle.
And then and then the final boss.
I think it would be cool if we could do a ship battle, but I don't think engineering will say okay.
I think that's good.
Yep.
So those are our bosses.
Those are our bosses.
And then the brunt of all of this work will start in May.
Yeah.
So So in the immortal words of Optimus Prime, all we need is a little Energon and a lot of luck.
Is that why you called this meeting is to have end? Like, end it with that line?
But the Luctopus might be a big monster instead of a little babe.
If that changes, then bad idea is up for debate.
Okay, that's fine.
I haven't even wrapped my mind about
it. Okay, me neither.
What we're going to do. So what
that
in my
boss
mind.
Is not getting done right now.
It's in the next milestone.
Yeah, and I can let everyone in the design channel know what's happening, especially Ben and JP, mm-hmm. just so that they're aware of the decisions that were made here.
Yeah. Is JP out today?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That whole team has been taken down with pestilence.
Ben? Pestilence.
What kind of pestilence?
I'm like a Warcraft.
Nobody has said.
Can you be specific about the symptoms?
They're just
that's what my necromancer
you can't just say that anymore. Sniffles?
More hand sanitizer, please.
Joshua's got the fever.
Yeah.
He was traveling too.
Well, he was in Scotland now.
Did anyone see him after he went out into the snow?
Jeff says he's got the flu. Yeah.
Jeff's got the flu?
That's what he said.
That's just PAX flu. You're fine.
Yeah, okay.
Just don't take any cruise ships while
you're yeah.
No, no. Why do people do that?
I was like, don't touch your face. And I was like, kissing my fingers.
My parents just came.
All right. Watch your gathering. Anything else? Anyone have any questions about anything? Did I forget anything? Anyone want to talk about anything? GDC was canceled.
Is there cake today?
That's kind of weird. Yeah, do we need to say anything about GDC being out? We might. Do we know yet? I think most things that were happening that week are canceled. Our Day of the Devs show at the Alamo is canceled. So.
Oh, really?
All the devs had to not come.
They haven't announced the specific plans, but GDC is going to be like still streaming some of the Indie Award show. So I guess they're still having one.
Lee Petty's on the board of, what's the board called? The Secret Star Chamber of GDC.
Well, I'm only on the visual arts.
No, I mean, I've heard from Sony employees that are not allowed to travel. Like, they're being told not to travel and anything like that. We have not gotten any sort of guidelines from that from Microsoft. They are just canceling their attendance to a lot of these events. I'm supposed to go to a big meeting in Seattle, and I'm like, Seattle, Washington's where they're having all these cases.
Have you?
Yeah. Thanks for letting us have this meeting remotely. I really did want to come up there and talk to you all in one room, but it's crazy times. Okay, great. I'll just run through a little overview of the game and show a video. These are the levels of the game now. This one was one of our E3 and our PAX demo. Have you seen this one? And you accidentally trigger a sort of a gambling problem in her mind, and you have to fix that.
Wow.
High-pressure Iron Chef cooking show type situation where he's being forced to cook meals really fast. Flat 2D type characters. Everything made of paper in the tomb of the sarcophagus.
This is so amazing.
That's good.
Yeah.
Incredible.
But it's fun seeing that all together because the team has been working for a long time where you just go level by level and work on the stuff. We're always like, do we have enough? Do we have enough in this game? Is there enough stuff in it? Maybe we need some more ideas. And then you put that video together and you're like, oh, okay, I think there's enough in there.
And there wasn't enough ideas in that game. No, I don't think so.
Yeah. The other thing that we've added in is that milestone where we're just going to be working on the bosses. And that was an initiative we've discussed. We feel like we're being very conscious of the bosses being really important and wanting to give them the time they need. And then budget.
Kelsey, is there anything in here that's a big surprise? I don't really think so, is there?
No, nothing in here is surprising.
Okay, great.
Great. Okay.
What's the general feel amongst the team of the the game? How do people feel about it? They're excited to work on it, feel good about it. Like, where's everybody at?
You know, they want to get things done. They want to have enough time to polish it and make it really good. But I think people feel really good about, you know, as long as we can execute on the quality of all the things that we have planned, that it'll be great. You know, I would say, you know, 90% of everything is nailed down as far as creatively speaking, and it's just a matter of execution.
So I think we're mostly aligned and good to go here. So we'll have a hands-on demo. This will be the first hands-on for the game. We'll have that as a consumer demo. And I should back up and say, if E3 is a show, it'll be hands-on for consumers. Well, this really is a seeing as a believing title, so we want to get as many people through the experience as we can.
All right.
Wow.
Do you have any...
Okay, thanks, everybody. Game looks great.
That's amazing.
Thank you.
Right on. Good. Awesome.
Thank you.
Thanks, everybody.
Bye, Dan. Bye,
see you next time.
Bye.
Hope to see you in person someday.
Bye-bye. Bye. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.
That went well.
There's your people.
Piece of cake. Should we go drink now?
Yes.
The one-year out meeting was last week for Psychonauts 2, and thanks to everyone who helped out putting together materials for it, we blew them away. The meeting went really well, and the important part of it for me was that the budget for rest of Psychonauts 2 was approved.
Yeah, you guys are here, and you're gonna get paid.
Yay!
We made this, like, 15-minute video of the entire game, which we'll share with you at some point soon, and it's amazing to see, you know, the whole game just, like, in that little micro window. It just looks insanely cool. And even the 30 seconds of Helmet just kind of, you know, knocked the room over. They were just going crazy for it.
You know, if you understand game development, you look at it, you're like, holy crap, there's a lot of cool stuff in that game.
A lot of stuff in this video game.
Yeah. Yeah.
So much stuff.
They're made of stuff.
It is.
Whether E3 will exist or not is pretty unknown. Seems kind of unlikely, but you know, Microsoft will do their own thing anyway, regardless of that. So we'll be part of something.
E3, canceled.
E3 is canceled.
Because E3 is now officially canceled, the need for a playable Pitch Perfect demo is greatly diminished, if not completely non-essential.
We did Helmet, and now there's no E3. I'm a little disappointed, but...
Are you gonna start working from home soon, you think?
I don't know. I'm gonna play it, feel it out. It's really hard to do my job working from home, though.
We should say something because people are like, what's up? What's going to happen?
Absolutely.
And does anyone here feel strongly about shutting the company down? Because some places have done that.
I think it sort of depends where people are coming from and what they have to
public transit
encounter on the
Although,
way here.
That's
public transit was empty today, so I felt super safe. Like, I was literally the only person on my train. I don't see us needing to close the studio at this time. I mean, does anyone disagree with that?
I'm open to it if people want to talk about it, but it didn't feel like we were there, especially if people are voluntarily working at home. That kind of lowers the risk for everyone who doesn't. So just to recap where we've been and what we've announced so far, we definitely telling people not to come in if they're feeling at all sick. I hope that's obvious to everybody, but even if you have the sniffles, just stay home and work from home. We do not want people bringing in an infection to the office, no toughing it out. If anyone feels more comfortable working at home during this period, we really want to encourage people to just go ahead and do that. And there's no shame in it, obviously. So any questions about that? It's not much of a real announcement, but we just want to make sure that people know where we stand on all that stuff.
Well, the coffee shop's closed, so I don't know how to survive now.
Oh, are they shut that down for COVID?
Yeah.
The Point is not open.
It's a ghost town outside. It's crazy. The freeways are empty. No one's coming to the city.
I didn't look right. Are we the last people here?
I think so.
Oh, maybe we are being too lackadaisical.
Why do you guys think the Point closed? I mean, obviously coronavirus, but like more specifically.
I think coronavirus.
Did they just close it as a precautionary measure for coronavirus?
Probably, yeah. Most bigger companies like Pinterest size are basically closing their shit down to outside visitors.
Makes sense. I got a friend who works just up the street, and their entire company is working from home for like next 2 weeks.
Yeah,
makes sense.
Yeah.
I've heard basically everywhere in the world right now is like in quarantine to some capacity. So,
which I mean, that'll help reduce spread of the virus. Like that'll do stuff.
I mean, Northern Italy is just like gone full. Don't go out of the fucking house, you idiots.
Yeah. Have you seen basically it's all of Italy now. It's not just Northern.
Oh, really? Oh yeah, shit. Front page, New York Times.
Oh man.
You think you're gonna be here for SDF Monday?
I don't know if anyone's gonna be here Monday. It's looking grim. And not in a good way. Can you hear him now?
Hello, do I sound good? Hi, welcome to my show, everybody. First caller. Ah! I hung up on everybody. Okay, it's a little rough. It's fine. It's gonna be great.
Yeah, Tim, we're all here. You want to kick it off?
All right. Hi, everybody. Can you hear me?
Hi.
Hello.
Welcome to my home. Hopefully you all saw the announcement about us going to full-on work from home starting next week. I think on this team in particular, Psychonauts 2, we have like a, you know, a challenging milestone already and then some deadlines and then it's all... it's all challenging, but I really I'm hoping we can just be extra communicative with each other and really still do our best to pull these levels together. You people who've been working remotely are, of course, our models who can show us the way for working at home and how, look how successful Ray is there working at home. Look how happy he is. We're all going to be as happy and peaceful as Ray soon.
All right.
Okay, then. Thanks, everybody.
Thanks, everybody. See you on the internet.
See you on the internet.
On the internet.
I guess one of the obstacles during game dev should have been biblical, so here we are.
There was no room for error.
Yeah.
And then this coronavirus thing happened, so that's it. Like, we're off the charts now. We are screwed. This milestone is totally fucked.
Ha ha ha.